Hello students, welcome back. In previous session, we have started exercise 16C and I have done fourth main two sums, okay? But there are four sums in that. So remaining two sums, I am going to continue in this session. Five and six I have given as a homework and that you are going to do in your homework book. So question number four, they have told here, find the resulting quantity. Question number four, they have told, find the resulting quantity. In previous session, I have calculated the first answer as rupees 32. I'm telling about the previous session. This question, first two I have done. Okay, what is that? Rupees 400 is decreased by 8%. What we got the answer? Rupees 32 we got. And the second one, 25 kilometer is increased by 5% they gave, no? So that I got the answer as it is 1.25 kilometer. I think only this much I gave the answer in that session. But it is the resulting quantity you have to write. What we have to do then? In the first case, original amount is rupees 400 and decreased, how much it is? Decreased we got here 32 rupees. Decreased means what I told you are going to subtract. So 400 minus 32 you have to do. 400 minus 32 you have to do. So 10, this is 9 and this is 3. 10 minus 2 is 8, 9 minus 3 is 6. 368 is the resulting amount of the first question. This part I have not done in our session, that I am telling you now. We calculated only till here. Okay, we got rupees 32. But they have asked your resulting quantity. Means in rupees 400, you have to subtract rupees 32. Decreased amount what we got. Why we have to subtract? Because they told it is decreased amount. Okay, so we got 368. In the second question, it is 25 kilometer and it is increased by 5%. So increased quantity what we got here, 1.25. That means this 25 kilometer should be added with 1.25 kilometer, right? So 1.25 kilometer we are going to add. Why we are adding? Because it told it is increased. So 2 will be as it is, 5 plus 1 is 6. So what is the resulting quantity it is here? It is 26.25 kilometers. These two results or these two answers you write with these two. Only we have calculated the increased quantity and decreased quantity, but we have not calculated the resulting quantity. They ask here resulting quantity. So that I have done first and two. First and second. Now I will continue the third one. What is their third one? Resulting quantity we have to find. The third one is a speed of 600 km per hour. A speed of 600 km per hour is increased by 12.5%. Is increased by 12.5%. So first let us find the increased value. So increased value is equal to directly I will write the formula here, okay? Increased value is equal to increased percentage into original value divided by 100. This I have shown you in the previous session, that formula I am writing here directly, okay? So increased percentage is how much? 12 whole 1 by 2 into original is 600 kilometer per hour. So 600 divided by what? 100. Here this is a mixed fraction. Convert this into improper first. 2 12s are 24 plus 1, 25 by 2 into 100, 600, sorry, divided by 100. So, zeros got cancelled. What is remaining here? 25 by 2 into 6. Because zeros we have cancelled, only 6 will remain. Okay. Now, 2 1s are, 2 3s are. Correct? Now, 25 3s are is how much? It is 75. 75. This is increased value we got. But we have to find the resulting quantity. Because it is increased, you are going to add this 75 to the original. Okay? So, resulting quantity is equal to resulting quantity is equal to 600 original value plus increased value 75. Because it told it is increased here, then we have to add it. So it is 675 is the resulting quantity. Okay, this is the solution of this third question in this fourth question, fourth main third question. Okay, so directly I have written the formula. I think you don't have any problem. Can you tell how to write this formula? So let me write that. Once I will tell that. Okay, increased percentage is equal to increased value divided by original value into 100. This is the formula. What I will do, I want this, no? This I am writing this side and this one I will write this side. So, increased value divided by original value into 100 is equal to increased percentage. I have written ulta of these two. Okay, this I wrote here and this one I wrote there. Now we want only the increased value. Okay, so increased value we want. So let us keep increased value here only. Increased value. So this side what will come? Increased percentage. I want to bring this original value to this side. Then it is multiplication because it is division here. Into original value, and here 100 is multiplied by. So I want to bring this side, means it will be divided. The same I have done here. This is how you have to transform the formula. Okay, I hope you understood this. Now let us go to the fourth sub question of fourth main. Fourth sub question is what in fourth main? It is, there is 2.5% increase. There is 2.5% increase. There is 2.5% increase in a salary of rupees 62,500. Here also increased percentage they have given. We have to find first increased value, then the resulting quantity we are going to find. Okay, solution. So original value is equal to rupees 62,500. Okay, now increased percentage they have given, write that. Increased percent is equal to 2.5%. Fine. Now you have to find the increased value. Increased value is equal to. So the same formula I am writing here. Here what we got now? This only I am writing. Increased value is equal to increased value is equal to increased percentage into original value divided by 100. Now write the values what they have given. Increased percentage is 2.5% into original value is 62,500 divided by 100. Now cancel the zeros. I have cancelled it. Now you have to do the multiplication of 625 and 2.5. Don't worry about the decimal point. First do the multiplication, then we will keep the point. Don't worry for that. Okay, 5 5s are 25, 2, I will write the carry here. 5 2s are 10 plus 2 12, 1 carry here. 5 6s are 30 plus 1 31. Now put the plus here. 2 5s are 10, 1 carry here. 2 2s are 4 plus 1 5, then 2 6s are 12. So you are going to add these 5 2 6 5 1, and where to put the point? See, after the decimal point there is only one digit. Then here also you have to put the point where after the decimal point there should be only one digit. So it is ₹1562.5 is the increased value. But still here it is not going to end. Still sum is there. What is that? You are finding the resulting quantity. So resulting quantity is equal to you are adding this to original value. Because it is increased, you have to add it. So that is ₹62,500 plus 1,562.5. Add both. 5 will be as it is here, put the point same. 0 plus 2 is 2, 0 plus 6 is 6, 5 plus 5 is 10, 1 carry I am giving here, 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4, and 6 will be as it is. So what is the resulting quantity? It is ₹64,062.5. That means 64,062.5 is the resulting quantity. I hope you understood this whole sum. Original value I have written, increased percentage. So increased value we have to calculate. For that I have written the formula, increased percentage into original divided by 100. So 2.5 is the increased percentage into the original value, that is 62,500 divided by 100. These zeros got cancelled. Then I have multiplied 625 with 2.5. We got the result here, 1,562.5. That I have added to the original. Final result we got 64,062.05. This is the fourth main solution 4. Now question number 5 and 6 I have given as a homework. So directly I will go for question number 7. After seeing this video, you have to try to do all the sums on your own. Then only you are able to solve in exam. Okay? So all try to solve on your own. Then question number 7. A tank can hold 50 liters of water at present at present it is only 30% full. How many liters of water shall I put into the tank so that it becomes 50% full. It becomes 50% full. This is question number 7. Okay, so let us start the solution. So according to this question, a tank can hold 50 liters of water. At present, it is only 30% full. How many liters of water shall I put into the tank so that it becomes 50% full? Okay, they have not asked you to find how much is required for 100% full. They asked here only to 50%. So let me tell you, if this is a tank, okay, if this is a tank, this is a tank, here only 30% is filled. 30% of water is filled. But they have asked here to find how much water is required to fill 50%. It is only 30%. And they have asked you to find how much water is required to fill 50%. This we have to find, how much water is required. Okay, so let us begin the solution. What it is, what they have given, let me write first. Capacity of a tank is 50 liters. Next, quantity of water at present is how much they have given. At present it is 30% is full. 30% is full. That means it is given in percentage. First find it in a what? In number. So quantity of water present in the tank. It is how much? 30% is already there, they told. So 30% of how many liters? 30% of total capacity, that is 50 liters. Out of 50 liters, 30% of water is already there. So you have to find the percentage into numbers. So 30 divided by 100 into 50. So zeros you cancel. Then 3 5s are 15. So 15 liter of water is there already in the tank. But the thing is, how much water is required to the tank to fill 50%, they have asked. So water required to the tank to fill 50%. So how much is the water? That will be equal to 50% means 50 divided by 100 into 100. They have given in percentage. I am calculating in numbers. Zero got cancelled. Here Sorry, they have not given 50%. It is how many percent is filled already? How many percent is filled already? It is 30% is filled. And it holds 50 liters. That means, see, 30% is filled means 20% still. Out of 50%, 20% still it should fill. So here, instead of what I am taking, instead of 50, I have to take 20. To fill 50%, that will be equal to 30% minus 20, it's not 30, 50% minus 30%. We need still what? 20%. Now we got the percentage, find it in quantity or number. So 20% of 50 liters we need still. That will be 20 divided by 100 into 50. Zeros you cancel, 2 5s are 10. So how much liters of water is required? It is 10 liters of water required to fill the tank to get up to 50%. How much it is? 10 liters. What I have done? Out of 50% already, 30% is filled. So how much we need? 20% we need. 20% of what? 20% of 50 liters we want. So if you calculate that, 20 divided by 100 into 50, it is 2 5s are 10 liters is required. This is the solution of question number 7. You want me to explain again? So let me tell that capacity of a tank is 50 liters. Out of that, quantity of water at present in the tank is 30%. So that quantity I have written, I have calculated in number, that is 30% of 50 liters. It is 30 divided by 100 into 50. That will be 15 liters is already there. Now, water required to the tank to full 50% means total 50%, if already 30% is there, means 50% minus 30%, that will be 20%. 20% of what? 20% of 50 liters. So this will be 20 divided by 100 into 50. So zeros cancelled, 2 5s are 10 liters is required. Okay, this is solution of question number 7. Now let us go to question number 8. Okay, so I will start question 8 here. Let me write that. In an election, there are a total of 80,000 voters. 80,000 voters and two candidates A and B. Okay, 80% of the votes go to the polls. Okay, now out of which 60% vote for A candidate. Okay, how many votes does B get? This is the question. Here in an election there are total of 80,000 voters and two candidates A and B. 80% of the votes go to the polls, means 80% of the people, they will come and vote. Now, out of which 60% vote for A, 60% of the people, they voted for candidate A. Then how many votes does B get? How many votes B will get? We are going to find the answer. Okay, so solution. Okay, total population it is 80,000. Okay, now and two candidates, we will not write that, later we will write that. Percentage of votes, percentage of votes, how many percent voted here? It is 80% of people, they have voted. Now candidate A got how many percent of votes? 60% of votes. Here they have given how much? It is 60% of votes. Then candidate B will get how much they are asking? B got how many percent of vote or how many votes he got? All they are in percentage. First we have to find it in numbers. So percentage of votes have given, then votes, number of votes we have to find, number of votes, that will be equal to 80% of 80% of 80,000. So that is 80 divided by 100 into 80,000. So how many votes or how much is the votes, total number of votes we will get here? 8 8s are 64 and 1 2 3 zeros. 64,000 votes it is voted. Now candidate A got 60%. So candidate A, we are writing in number. Candidate A got 60% of 80,000 votes. 60% of 80,000 votes. So 60 divided by 100 into 80,000. Cancel the zeros. So how much it is? 8 6 are 48 and 3 zeros. 48,000 votes are votes they have gone to candidate A. Now candidate B got, let me write that here. It is okay if I write here because I don't have the place there. So I will draw the line. This solution I am continuing here. Candidate B got out of 80,000 people, 64,000 people they have voted, and A got 48,000, B got, total number of votes we have to write here. So that is 64,000 minus candidate A, how much he got, that we have to write, 48,000. Then we will get the votes candidate B got. So 0 minus 0 will be 0, 0 minus 0 will be 0, 0 minus 0 will be 0. Now from 4 you cannot subtract 8. Take the borrow, this is 14 and this will be 14 and this will be 5. Okay, so 14 minus 8 is how much? It is 6. Then 5 minus 4 is how much? 1. So how many votes candidate B got? 16,000 votes candidate B got. I hope this whole sum you understood. Okay, so first you write, you find it in numbers, total number of votes and candidate A got, then both if you subtract you will get the vote got by candidate B. So this is the end of this session. Homework for this session you are going to do question number 9 and only question number 9 you do. Question number 10 and 11 I will do in the next session. So let me give the homework here. Homework, the same exercise, question number 9. Only one question I'm giving as a homework. Okay, bye, take care, thank you.